Drew Tube. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up to Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Say no shade. Hey YouTube, how's it going today? God bless and everybody's all right out there, I pray. Well, I just want you to know that I really don't have an opinion one way or another about as to whether this woman is alive, this young lady, or if she's really dead. But what I do want to speak about is she's a beautiful young girl, you must admit. And, you know, depending on who's the right Kanika, who's the wrong Kanika, whether she is dead, may she rest in heaven, or if she's still alive, may God have mercy on her and her family. But what I really want to say about this is, with this young lady, is that when there's such a divide amongst black people, people in general, there's usually somebody out there being conquered. And it just seems like between Facebook and YouTube that there's a lot of people who believe that she's still alive and that her family has a lot to do with this conspiracy theory, PSYOP, or again, great divide and conquer scheme. And usually what it does is it puts people at odds with one another. Of course, you got the ones who believe she's still alive, you have the ones who believe she's dead. But what I'm basically trying to say here is there's another situation like this that happened pretty much 2,000 years ago with a man named Yeshua, with the Christ, with the Messiah. And upon his death, just like Kanika, whether you believe he was hung on a tree or whether you believe he was crucified, as the good book tells us, on a cross, it caused a great divide, and somewhere then somebody had got conquered, and it was the children of Israel, the people who were sold into slavery, and we're the descendants of those people still being divided and conquered by situations like Kanika Jenkins or situations surrounding people's death, whether they're dead, alive, and how did they die. And like I said, I'm going to get into more of a teaching about Christ in and of himself, how he died, or how, because you can't die two ways. And just like Kanika, she can't die two ways. And there's several different theories out there about how she passed away or if she's still living. Again, like I said, I'm not going to comment on that because I have not been following the story. But God spoke to my heart, Yahweh spoke to my heart and said, you know, with everything going on with this great divide and conquer, people at war with one another, people hating on one another, people can't agree with their adversary quickly so that they cannot be brought before the judge, as the Bible would say. It reminds me so much of Yeshua, of the Messiah, of Christ, the King of Righteousness and the King of Shalom, the one after the order of Melchizedek, and the one to this day who still has Christianity, who has Jews, Muslims, everybody at odds, again, the great divide and conquer in this situation right here. So, basically, what I'm just saying here, guys, is, you know, it's kind of sad that a young girl like this in our community, in a black community, would be used in a situation like this if it was a scam, if it was a flag, if it was a PSYOP. And it's also sad if this young girl was murdered for her body parts or for any gang-related activities she may have been involved. That's being reported, allegedly. Again, I think there's a lot of similarities here with her and with Yeshua, with the Christ. Meaning, upon their death, the Bible says in one account that he was hung on a cross, and we know that the Roman Catholics, the Roman Empire, uses their cross as a ministration of death. They hang their criminals on the cross. And then, if you read the book of Acts 5 and 13, 5 and 29, hold on, let me be very precise with this. Give me one second. If you read the book of Acts, I know it's 5. I always like to say 5 and 30, but there's a little bit more to it. If you read the book of Acts from 28, Acts 5, 28 down to 33, you get an absolutely clear understanding that a couple of the Pharisees and the scribes at that time, not too long, remember, the book of John is right before the book of Acts, and in the book of John, the Bible says that Christ was crucified on the cross, and that two robbers hung on the side of him. But then when you flip the pages a little bit and go to the book of Acts, and if you go to the chapter 5, and if you start with verse 28, it pretty much tells you that the Pharisees and scribes and Sanhedrins of that day, the rulers of that day, approached followers of Christ and made a comment that pretty much, didn't we tell you not to be preaching anything in that name? Here, let me go on and read verse 28 for you so you understand exactly what it is I'm saying. So it says here in verse 28, "Did not we straitly command you that you should not teach in this name? And behold, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us." Okay. And then in 29, it goes on to say, Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, "We ought to obey God rather than men." And it goes on in verse 30 that says, "The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom I believe this name Jesus is of a Greek origin and was inserted in parts of the Bible. His name was Hebrew," and if you look up the name Jesus, it will tell you that the name Jesus is a Greek origin, but it's a rendition of a Hebrew name, Jesus, Yeshua. So when I read the Bible, I plug the name Yeshua in where I see Jesus. But verse 30 says, "The God of our fathers who raised up Yeshua, whom you slew and hanged on a tree." And then it goes on to say that in 31, "Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be prince and savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins." 32 goes on to say, "And we are his witnesses of these things, and so is also the Holy Ghost, whom God hath given to them that obey him." And then 33 goes on to say, "When they heard that they were cut to the heart and took counsel to slay them." Meaning, when they heard that, we know you killed Christ on a tree, hung him on a tree, and there's some significance with that and backing that up in the Bible. We won't go into it right now, but there was witnesses that saw a hanging on a tree. And the Holy Ghost will bear witness with that as well. And then you have another account of Christ being crucified on the Roman's cross. And just like here in the Kenneka Jenkins case, you have a young girl who Undoubtedly, everybody says that she died in a freezer. But the reason why she died, was it because she was drunk in that hotel and somehow somebody got her body parts and she was set up by her friends and the hotel staff to have this done to her? Or was it gang related? Nonetheless, this situation here, this death here, just like in the death of Christ, has brought a great divide and conquer. And like when you're so divided out there in the world like this, somebody is being conquered somewhere. And we know that there's slaves being sold over in Libya for $400. We also know that there's slavery going on in America now that Trump and his people are in the presidency. But we have to be mindful that when situations like this happen, in Kanika Jenkins' case, we got to find some way to stay united and allow it to bring us together. Because just like in the case of Christ, he has so many followers and so many people into him and into what he was saying that God, Yahweh, sent him to say that whether you believe he was killed on the cross, the Romans way, the Appian way, and that cross was used as a instrument of torture, or whether you feel that with backed up scripture and with Paul even saying in the book of Galatians, any man that hangs from a tree is cursed. Who hung in the tree on the tree besides Judas in the Bible? Because there's an account that Judas, after he disrespected Christ and betrayed him, that he hung himself from a tree. Some people will go on and say that this is because he was being remorseful and regretful and wanted to die the same way that Christ died. And there's an account that over 150 verses are scripture about, I shouldn't say scripture, I should say that tree is mentioned over 150 times in the Bible compared to 19 times that the cross is mentioned. So basically, guys, what I'm pretty much trying to say here is when Christ was crucified, glorified crucifixion for the Christians to follow and worship the ministration of the Romans' way of killing people, or if you think he was actually killed on a cross, inspired and ordained by God to receive that everlasting life. Because if you look at it in the book of Genesis, there was the tree of life in the book of Genesis when they partook of the tree of the good and the evil, the knowledge of the good and evil. And if you read the book of Genesis, I believe 3, at the ending of it, somewhere around 3:22 is somewhere. Let me just make sure I have the word here with me. But God says it was better for them if they would have put their hand to the tree of life. And it goes on to say that right here in 22, as I was saying. And the Lord God said, behold, this is Genesis 3:22. And the Lord God said, behold, the man has become as one of us to know good and evil. And now lest he put forth his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat and live forever. And that's, you know, basically I'm starting to realize that God connected trees to be the beginning of life and to be the end of life and not so much a cross. So with that being said, put your comments in down below. Like, subscribe, and share this video. Because again, my take on this, like I said, I don't have an opinion one way or another. I prayed about it, gave it up to, I talk everything up to Yahweh. But he said, well, why don't you just share the similarities of, there's different reasons why Kanika Jenkins is said to be dead or alive. And there's different reasons for Christ, the Yeshua, the Messiah, to have died. And we know he's risen, but did he rise from the cross? Or did he die on the cross? Or did he die on the tree and then rose and ascended? Well, there's no doubt about him rising and ascending, but And there's questions in relation to Kanika Jenkins. Is she still alive? Is she dead? You know, so there are some similarities here. Kanika in no way is God. But there are stories for a time such as this right now, for a learning experience, for people to look at this and say, wait a minute, there is some truth here. Open up your eyes, people. Open up your ears, people. The book of Romans says that we have a slumber asleep on us. The book of Romans says we have a slumber asleep on us. I do apologize, you two. In the book of Romans 11, verse 8, it says, as according as it is written, God hath given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear, unto this day. And what he's talking about is due to blindness in part, because back in the book of Deuteronomy 28, verses 15 through 68, it outlines the curse. In the first verse there, in the chapter 28, in verse 1, Moses was given a commandment, an ordinance to tell the people that God says, listen, hearken unto my voice this day, you'll be blessed. Hearken unto my voice this day, you'll be cursed. And they were told that all throughout the Bible because of their disobedience, unbelief, and doubt. And that's why Yeshua came up to deal with the unbelief, disobedience, and the doubt. So here in the book of Romans 11:8, it says pretty much that unto this day, a lot of our community, a lot of the black people, a lot of the people in the world, even the ones who say they're woke, have the spirit of sleep and slumber over them. They may be woke to the things that's going on in the world, but spiritually, they're not woke to the truth. And until you get woke to the truth, you will never be set free. And people will always be able to come into your community, your homes, your schools, our culture, our workplaces, and divide and conquer us. And once a person, once a nation, once a entity is divided and conquered, that comes the prejudice, the racism, the hate, the bitterness, the angry, the betrayal, and everything, and you know, that goes along with that. So again, my hope, my prayer is that we can find some way to unite behind Kanika Jenkins, and for the love of God, at some point in time, be able to find our ways to unite for the sake of Christ. And I know that is not going to happen, believe you me. I do know that's not going to happen. But one thing I do know, if you look to encourage, exhort, and comfort people with the truth, with the what thus saith the Lord, not saying that the whole Bible is scripturally right and sound doctrine, because I'm doing my research on that as well, but what we have to go by, we can line Kanika Jenkins up with having some similarities to the way Christ died. As you all are out there talking about how she died, there's some truth in their cases being similar, because there's questions again about how Christ died that's being raised now from the same said Bible. So with that being said, guys, listen, however you feel about Kanika Jenkins and about Christ, in no way can people die two different ways. I just want you to be aware of that. Stay woke, open your eyes, open your ears, ask God to take that slumber of that spirit of slumber off of you, so that you're not just looking at things with your natural eyes and your natural ears, hearing with your natural ears, but your spirit man begins to perceive with the eyes and then begins to understand with the ears, because Christ said so many times in his ministry, let those who have ears hear. And I'm asking you to do the same thing. God bless you all. Yahweh bless. Y'all bless. You know, subscribe, like, share, comment, and, you know, make this video go viral because, again, truth shall set you free.